Before we get started with this episode, we have a quick announcement. As many of you know, YouTube has been conducting a purge of sorts of cannabis-related content from their platform. Because of this, we have also begun to post our content to BitChute. Now, I doubt at this point that we're in any danger of getting blasted from YouTube because we're a very new channel and our audience is, well, rather small at this point. But just in case, if by chance we disappear from YouTube, you can continue to follow us at our other location. Now let's get on with the show. This is it. Today on Fudpucker Farms, we're going to find out who the boys and girls are. We're going to spend some more time delving into my philosophy with the biodynamic calendar, and we're going to time our transplant schedule in alignment with that calendar. Are you ready? Let's go. Hey gang, we're beginning today conducting a sex test on this propagation of cannabis. 8 of the 9 seeds that I dropped germinated in this crop, which by chance I happened to purchase 8 tests, so I'm good with that occurrence. This is the first time that I've employed this kind of a test, and as you can see, I've chosen to do business with Phylos Bioscience for this test. The reason I chose to do this is probably pretty obvious. It's going to save me a ton of time in waiting for Mother Nature to tell me who's who. Plus, it's going to save me a lot of effort that goes along with my chosen growing style. It's also going to save me some kashizzle along the way, which you'll never hear me complain about. Now, I've collected all the materials that I need, as you can see. This portion of the process is really a very simple task. You cut off cotyledon leaves off of each plant, and you pound some of that plant material onto the test card. You label the corresponding plant tests, and when you've completed that entire process, you ship the cards off to Phylos, and after a few days, they drop you an email, and they let you know what your results are. And here's what we have. Of the 8 plants that germinated, we have 5 males and 3 females. What's uncanny to me is the universe in its infinite wisdom gave me a female from each of the breeders that I chose to work with, and that, quite frankly, put a big smile on my face. Armed with this information, now that lets me set the course for the next phase for these plants, which brings us into the how and when I transplant. And for that, we're going to take a look at the biodynamic calendar. Now, before I jump right into the specifics of my tuned-in game plan, I noticed a comment on YouTube about how a subscriber thought this was a bunch of hooey until my previous video shed a little light into his thinking. And that's where I'm going to start with this portion of the video. I mentioned in an earlier video that there's a pulse or a rhythm to the universe that we live in. Unfortunately, there's a lot of misconceptions that find their roots in what we've been force-fed through our public school education. You see, the vast majority of us have been taught that our solar system revolves around the sun in concentric circles like this. Well, I hate to break it to you, but that's just incorrect. Let's look at our moon's orbit. The truth is, that orbit is elliptical, or an oval shape. At apogee, the moon is the furthest away from us, and at perigee, it's the closest. When the full moon coincides with the perigee, and that's what's called the super full moon, which is a term that I'm sure that all of you have heard of. Additionally, the moon does not fly in a linear fashion either. It flies in a wave or a corkscrew pattern that creates a vortex, and this is evidenced by the last year's much-hyped total solar eclipse. As you can see here, the path of that eclipse didn't travel straight across the map in a linear fashion, but rather it had an arc to it. Now let's take that concept out a little further. The Earth's orbit around the sun is also elliptical, and yes, you guessed it. The truth is a lot closer to this. The sun is hauling us and the entire solar system through space with all the planets in an elliptical, vortex-creating orbit. And if we take this concept out just one more level, you're right again. The sun is also flying through the Milky Way on a 226 million year long elliptical oscillating wave vortex creating orbit. And when you add all the suns, planets, and moons together flying like this, you get this pulse. What it boils down to is this variable motion creates frequencies of electromagnetic energy. And if you think that all this doesn't affect everything on this planet, which includes you and your plants, well, you need to think a little harder. Now that we're back down to Earth, let's have a quick refresher on the calendar. Remember when I showed you the color coding of the calendar and its relation to one of the four elements of fire, water, earth, and air, and the corresponding plant types of fruit, leaf, root, and flower? We're going to focus on two of these sections, the red hours, which for this video corresponds to my tomato crop, and the yellow hours, which corresponds to my flowering plants. You know, it's often said that timing at certain points of your life is everything, thus the title to this video. Now let's delve into why I aligned this work with the biodynamic calendar. Here we are in April. When I started to plan my year out back in January, I figured out then that I would be conducting my sex testing and transplanting out of my propagation tray here on Saturday the 21st of April because we're in a flower period on the calendar. I also knew back then that I'd be transplanting my tomatoes here on the 25th during a fruit period. The reason I planned this way also corresponds with the coming days on the calendar. As you can see down here, there is an 80-hour period of root time following this transplant window. Armed with that information, I knew that my tomatoes would recover and quickly reestablish their roots in my raised beds, and my flowers would be able to blow out a 1-gallon pot in the 8-day time frame between the window on the 21st and the next transplant window on the 30th. So let's get to that part of this project now. If you look here on the calendar, you see a water period denoted in blue that occurs roughly 48 hours prior to or before the transplant window for my tomatoes. Now, prior to transplanting, during that water window, I prepare my plants with a good dose of B vitamins. As you can see here, I'm using B1 from Mad Farmer. And I also water my plants with some biology. Here, of course, I'm using Recharge. By doing this, it helps prepare my plants for the transplant, and it helps them to recover quicker from any transplant shock that they might experience, which I know from my experience, my tomatoes here are not going to like this displacement at all. Another note here, whenever I transplant, I add mycorrhizae into the root zone, as you see here. This year, I'm trying a new formulation from Mycobloom. They propagate mycorrhizae from one of the Earth's great agricultural zones, the Great Lakes and Midwest region of the United States. Growing up on a farm in this region, I have an understanding as to the rich soil biology that's found there, which is why I chose to try this product. Now that transplant shock that I mentioned on my tomatoes, you see what I mean? Their recovery, however, was roughly 24-hour period, pretty short, because they were prepared 48 hours prior to this transplant. Now let's move on to transplanting my flowers. Looking back at the calendar, I noted previously this small flowering window on the 30th of April, and I need to take advantage of that because we don't get another good transplant window in the Northern Hemisphere until the 18th or 19th of May. So the course has been set. Propagation tray to 1 gallon on the 21st and 1 gallon to 5 gallon on the 30th. And I'll be moving these flowers into their final home here on the 19th of May, which will give them a full month to establish prior to entering into their transition period between vegetative state and flowering. Now, another layer to my method here. Back in my soil build video, I mentioned layering and spiking techniques. Here I employ a layering technique to this transplant. This layering is placed roughly an inch or so below where the roots are going to be when I put this plant into this 5-gallon pot. This lower layer is a mix of vegetated focused amendments. I blend alfalfa meal, blood meal, kelp meal, and some oyster shell flour. Now, here you can see, just as I knew would happen, in the 8 days since being placed into this 1 gallon pot, these flower roots have outgrown this 1 gallon container. After I get this placed and backfilled with more soil, then I add another layer on top of the plant. This is nitrogen-rich bat guano, which is going to help these plants step on the gas here in the first 19 days of May, and it will help to ensure that this plant will blow out this 5 gallon pot in the next 20 days. Now I think you're starting to see some of the method to my farming madness. As you continue to watch this series, I'm going to continue to lay out this practice, which is going to even become more interesting as we go through the month of May. And if you choose to adapt this practice, it's really quite easy to create your plan, not only for transplanting, but for planting your entire garden space. I'm going to wrap this video up with a couple of Growers Love shoutouts. First to a new subscriber, Cute Lisa. Thanks for coming on board and tuning in to what I'm laying down here. It's great to know that there are some interested lady growers out there. Next to Mad Farmer. Thanks for the samples of your B1 product. As you can see, I'm putting it to good use. You can check them out at madfarmerproducts.com. And last, to Mycobloom. After discovering your product, I'm pretty excited to see how it performs in my gardens this season. I got a feeling it's going to knock it right out of the park. You can check them out at mycobloom.com. Some trolls are going to take us through the credits today. Thanks everybody for watching. We'll see you on our next video. I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric wavy when I turn it on. And if you want it inside your soul, just open up your heart, let music take control. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. The room unlocked the way we rock it, so don't stop.